money, so the soda keep on coming. Phone ringing, so you know the nota jumping. They looking at me, he owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the night crumping.
Why playing?
All right, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Seattle Seahawks and the San Francisco 49ers. That'll be taken in the end zone. First and 10, it's Wilson. Throws a quick hitter on the slant, that's complete. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
First carry for Nick Chubb. It goes as a gain of 8 and it moves the chains.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They run again on first down. Chubb trucks through him.
Oh, man, right through it.
And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On second down, flushed out right. Wilson hit, it's loose, it's out, fumble.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback, the ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And this is going to be incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Fielded at the 20. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here, first and 10 at the 31-yard line.
I got you.
Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jerick McKinnon. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
For 22 and a first down.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle. Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ended up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Dancing to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Garoppolo escapes the sack, eluding the pressure right, flush to his right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
They certainly thought they had him surrounded and probably thought they were going to get him on the ground and get the sack, but he was able to elude that. And even though it threw it incomplete downfield, if you're a defensive back, you're loving the pressure that you're seeing from your front.
And the win last week punted four times as this one's away. And this will be touchdown inside the 20. They'll spot it at the 18-yard line. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On second down, here's Wilson. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great here either.
Yeah, and they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again, just like last week. Each game is its own entity, treated as such.
Third down, Wilson. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
I think the punter might start to get into a pretty good rhythm here if he keeps getting opportunities. But that's the last thing his team wants to have happen, right? The last thing you want to see is your punter feeling pretty good because he's out there all the time.
Yeah, first quarter only, but they're 0 for 2 on third down conversions to start this thing. A good return there, 17 yards. And that will come the offense as they take over. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive.
21.
Go ahead. Garoppolo now, first down throw. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41.
I got you. 12, fellas, here we go.
Now McKenna, and he fumbled it. It's on the ground, and they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
95.
Off the play fake, here's Wilson. And they're not able to hook up there, incomplete. The turnover put them in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass.
14.
From the gun, it's Wilson. And Eifert has it. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. Four. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
They'll run with Chubb. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number 1 against the run. But it's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against them either.
Alongside my broadcast partner Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number 2. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Now from the 7, here's 2nd and goal. Play action. It's Wilson. Steps away. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. Jeff Swain, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Give him 4 yards there, but they're still well short of the goal line with fourth down now looming. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. So still no touchdowns in the first half, but we do have some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game, because anytime you can get to the red zone, and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this one, being able to kick field goals means you're right there, and then you're just looking for that big break to take you over the top.
The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
Being chased out left. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's McKinnon, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Now Garoppolo throwing on second, escaping the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep, and that's caught inside the 35. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big play there for the Niners. 48 yards.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket, because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. Forced out to his left. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Working from the gun, Garoppolo shedding the tackle. And he slides to avoid the hit. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll make it third and one. Some time right. He can run for it, and he will. Just a yard, but that's all they needed, and by the slimmest of margins, it'll be first and goal.
These type of plays are backbreakers for a defense. They thought they had him hemmed in, thought they were going to get him on the ground with the pass rush, but were unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets up first and goal inside the 10.
21.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Now from the nine, here's second and goal. Now they'll throw with Garoppolo. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. Able to get nine out of that pitch and catch, but now third and goal.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
They'll try and run with McKinnon. And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Jerick McKinnon with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Niners are able to cash in for 6. Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep.
Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Now a play fake here on first down. He targets Jordan Matthews, and it's caught. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards.
They don't want it. 95.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's going to get forward for about 5, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They go play action here on first down. Caught, Eifert over the middle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A minute 59 to go in the first half. We'll come back here right after this. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They pitch it to Chubb. This carry with the extra effort is going to get him stopped up just shy of the 10. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Oh, yeah! It's on 50, it's on 50.
They go with Chubb on 2nd down. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Nick Chubb, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Seahawks are able to strike for 6. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Extra point up and good by Bailey. And the lead is now 10-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Flushed out right. Now the ball comes loose, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down. Second down. Buying time to his left. And he slings one that's incomplete. The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin. And it's third down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. 65. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter. A lot of time to change things. Garoppolo, and an alley to run. Now a loose football, the ball comes out, and the Seahawks have recovered.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football.
So should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Wilson. Complete to the right side. It's Eifert. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime.
Hey, clear.
Now Wilson. There's Baldwin. Touchdown, Seattle. Doug Baldwin, his first touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Garoppolo on first down. Steps away to his left. Deep ball for Goodwin. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. Touchdown, 49ers. Marquise Goodwin, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly for six. Oh, he missed it. No good. So this remains a four-point game. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
35 seconds, all that remains in the first half as they come up on first down. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
On second down, Wilson. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. So we've come upon halftime with the visiting Seahawks. They're out in front. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 26.
Go ahead. 11.
On first down, Garoppolo. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
His struggles finding open receivers continue. I don't know the last time I saw him this inconsistent throwing the football.
It would be hard to find a date when he was this inconsistent. You know, in his locker, he keeps the word poise printed on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. He needs to find that poise right now.
He certainly does. In fact, I would suggest he laminate it.
Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Malik McDowell there to make the tackle.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
The Niners on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 9. Garoppolo looks to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
Returnable for Lockett. Gets past one man. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. Here comes the Seahawks offensive unit. They'll have it first to begin the third. They were able to get the ball back here. Didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28.
Whenever I go to a team's practice facility and watch them work, I love to watch the defensive guys in what they call pursuit drills. The ball goes either towards them or away from them. How fast will they respond? On this play, the defensive end responded better than anyone and made a really nice play.
Now Wilson on second down. He's going to air one out. He's got a man complete. And that one results in 35 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Again, this is Chubb. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They go play action now. Wilson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. The Seahawks on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 9. From the shotgun, Wilson. And he's got Lockett. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Wilson to Lockett there for the Seahawks first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. Got his man. It's Eifert. He's dropped just inside the 20. A little second effort there, but couldn't find a whole lot of space. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Again, Wilson. To the left side here for Eifert. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 90 yards receiving now for him in the ball game. It's a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
They'll give it to him up the middle. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. Play action. Now Wilson. Rolling to his right. Throw across his body and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage. But instead, he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Now McKinnon to start the drive. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
The opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. On second down, here's Garoppolo. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
The Niners on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 4. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And that is incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field and it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. Now it's Lockett. Nice move at the 40. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
On second down, here's Wilson. And the catch good, it's Eifert. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now on the afternoon. Wilson now perfect since the second half started, 7 of 7. It's first and 10. Play action, it's Wilson, rolling to his left. To the left side here for Eifert. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A run for Nick Chubb. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Well, that looked like an example of what you said back in the first half. A running back of his size can really wear down a defense. I think he's starting to do that.
I think you're exactly right. And know what else he's doing? He's inspiring the rest of his team because they see this starting to happen as well. So that means they're going to redouble their efforts to help him out. Extra blocking, getting downfield, helping him out.
And able to get him inside the 5 here, just inside the 5 to about the 4. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Three down. Let's go. Rush it. Come on, let's go.
Oh. On the ground, it's Chubb. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line.
If they're going to get a first down out of this, they're going to have to earn it because there's been tough going in the interior there. And here we are on 3rd and 1. Be prepared. Brace yourself. Could be some contact going on.
The Seahawks on 3rd down. 2 for 5 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Oh, they go with a tight end carry. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a 1-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing on 1st is Garoppolo. And the Seahawk defense gets to him, and they bring him down. Frank Clark in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on 2nd down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Staying on his feet, and the pressure gets to him again. Jaron Reed, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. So the sack of Garoppolo, 21. And now what can they come up with on 3rd and long? On play action, it's Garoppolo sliding out of the pocket. Now he'll let it go deep right side. Oh, he can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get him to 4th down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And taken right on the 30. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a 1-score game. And you hear a lot about 2-minute offense and 4-minute offense. Obviously, the 4-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
They're over the 4-minute offense.
Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. DeForest Buckner, he's the one to get him. And that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on 2nd down. Now a man who played collegiately here in the Golden State, Rashad Penny. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That one will go down as 33 yards on the third down conversion. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. A toss play to Chubb, and he'll get about 3 as he's brought down to the 28. And now defensively they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. And again, it's Chubb. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Chubb will get the call, running left. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. And now here comes the third of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the 2-minute warning to stop it from here on out. This is Chubb on the toss. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Nick Chubb, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Here we go, hurry up, hurry up.
Now a play fake here on first down. Keeps himself upright. A dump down to McKinnon. And a great move again. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Dancing to his left. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
All right, that one fell incomplete there, but the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better that it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey.
Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. On play action, now Garoppolo. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. A rough couple of weeks for the man under center. 5 sacks last week, 4 now this week. Do you try to design some quicker developing plays if you're an offensive coordinator?
I think you do that. I think you also change his launch point at times. In other words, move your pocket to the right, to the left.
roll him out, bootleg him, do some different things so they can't just rely on the fact that he's going to take 3 to 5 steps back in the pocket and line up and throw the football.
Yeah, current formula is not working right now. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Garoppolo now, first down throw. Pressure comes, he's taken down by the Seahawk defense. Malik McDowell in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. Here we go,
here Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me, long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it, and he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
Second down. Being chased out left. And he is into the end zone for the touchdown. So they still need a miracle for the clock where it's at, but they get one piece to the puzzle done.
Still have hope. I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1 to 5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1 to 5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
Yeah,
you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
The Seahawks in victory formation as they go ahead and take the knee. Take that for granted no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for the Seahawks, they move back over 500 at 7-6. And they will head home next week to take on the Washington Redskins. Meanwhile, for the Niners, it's a loss that could have implications on the playoff race as they fall to 9-4. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Heinz Field to take on the Steelers. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden, alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.